Hello everybody, my name's Melissa and welcome back to my channel, Hopeful Happenings. Social media has taken the literary world by storm. It's exciting and it can also be a little nerve-wracking if you don't know how to do it right. Today we're going to talk about Twitter pitch contests, what they are, who can be involved, and how you can do it right so that you land a literary agent at the end. Okay, so what is a Twitter pitch contest? Well, a Twitter pitch contest is an event that allows people to directly pitch their book to an agent or an editor through a tweet. Each pitch must be only one tweet, so you can't have threads, but you're allowed to do multiple tweets throughout the contest. Now, this contest only happens a couple times a year, and it will be searchable through a hashtag. For example, there's hashtag DVPit, DVPit welcomes books featuring marginalized voices that are underrepresented in publishing. There's also hashtag PitMad, which is for any genre in books, and it's quarterly. Agents and editors will search tweets on the day of the event by the hashtag, and if they like your pitch, as in they do like the heart symbol like your pitch, then that means that they would like you to send them your material. And you can go to their personal page to see what their submission guidelines are. All right, so who can enter? Any unagented author can enter this contest so long as they have a manuscript, the one that they're pitching, obviously, a manuscript that is complete and fully polished, ready for submission. For nonfiction, you must have a polished proposal. Okay, so is it even worth it? Heck yes. Just with DVPit alone, over 80 authors have signed with agents and over 35 book contracts have been made that were direct results of the Twitter pitch contest. And that's only since they started in 2016. Editors from small up to big five publishing companies have participated in these Twitter pitch contests and requested material. And if you didn't know, a Twitter pitch contest is also how I actually landed my own agent for my first manuscript. Okay, let's talk about the nitty-gritty. How do you write a pitch that will land you an agent? The key is in planning. You're not going to do as well as you could if you try to wing it. Write your pitches in advance and then determine what order you're going to put them in throughout the contest. Now, you're going to need to go to their websites to see what amount of pitches you're allowed and how long the contest lasts. For the contest that I participated in, it was specifically for fantasy writers and it was 10 hours long. We were allowed to do 10 pitches, one per hour. I just looked at the PitMad requirements though, and they are allowing only 3 pitches throughout the contest, but you are allowed to pitch multiple manuscripts, so 3 per manuscript. However many times they will let you pitch, and by the way, you should be using all of the opportunities to pitch that you can, you probably will always be allowed to at least pitch 3 times. How you want to divide these pitches is by emphasis. One pitch should have an emphasis on character. The second pitch should have an emphasis on plot, and your third pitch should have an emphasis on the world building. Obviously, if you have a sci-fi or fantasy, world building is going to play a bigger part than if you were, say, using a contemporary manuscript. However, it's important to go from different angles to get a well-rounded view of your manuscript. For me, like I said, I was able to pitch 10 times. So I did 3 with an emphasis on character, 3 with an emphasis on plot, 3 with an emphasis on the world, and then I used my last pitch to do a comparable title. And I'll get to that in a moment. Your character, plot, and setting pitches all must have one thing in common. That thing is stakes. Tell us what is at stake. We need to know what's at stake if we want to care about your characters at all. Will their friendship be over if they don't save the party? Will a bomb blow up the postal car if they don't find the package in time? Are people going to die here? Give us the steaks! I hope I drilled that into you enough. Netflix is the perfect place for inspiration on short pitches that hone down the stakes. Go there and take notes, my friend. If you're in a contest that allows you to pitch more than three times, then you're going to want to use one of your extra Twitter pitches to do comparable titles. Okay, for example, if I was James Dashner and I was submitting a Twitter pitch on The Maze Runner, then a comparable title tweet might look something like this. Divergent meets Lord of the Flies. A dystopian society forces a group of boys to escape a maze or die trying. Did you catch the stakes? Comparable titles show agents that you know your competition, that you know your market. It also helps the agents and editors visualize your story better because they have something to work off of. Don't use more than one tweet on comparable titles. Although comparing to another work is a great way to get someone's attention, you still need to pitch your story. Also, if you have comparable titles in multiple tweets, you're either saying the same thing over again and wasting space, or you're comparing it to different things and just creating confusion. Now, how to schedule your posts is almost just as important as the pitch itself. Thousands of people are going to be participating in these contests, and more people participate each time. You need to stand out, and one way that you can do that is by posting your strongest pitch first. Your second strongest pitch can be posted around lunchtime, let's say like about 11 to 1 Eastern Standard Time. And your weakest pitch should be posted last. This is a little bit of common sense because the longer that a pitch is up there, the more chances an agent will see it. And so you want your strongest one to be out there the longest. Also, other people are allowed to retweet your pitches for more views. So the longer it's out, the more retweets are possible. If you're not sure which pitch of yours is the strongest, then I highly suggest that you pitch to someone else. Get feedback from someone that you trust, someone who is willing to be brutally honest with you, because you only have such a short window to grab someone's attention, and it's important that it counts. There you have it, guys. Those are all my tips for becoming a Twitter pitch success story and landing a literary agent. For more information on these contests, I will have their websites linked down below. Thank you so much for watching. I post once a week on YouTube and I post daily on Instagram. So please check me out. I have writing advice and I post about my own writing journey. Best of luck with this. We'll see you next week. Bye.